friends. This month is October, and in October we celebrate Halloween. And that's where you get dressed up, you go out trick-or-treating, some people might have a party, so all kinds of things. So this year might look a little different, but hopefully things will be okay. This is called Froggy's Halloween. It's by Jonathan London. That's who wrote the book, that's the author, and illustrated by Frank Remkiewicz. Not very good at that. He is the one that did the pictures. So let's read and see about Froggy's Halloween. For Froggy, Halloween meant candy, but it also meant dressing up. And he wondered, what should I be for Halloween? What do you think you're going to be for Halloween? I know, cried Froggy. Super Frog. Flying high over the city faster than a dragonfly. Stronger than a bullfrog. So there he is, Super Froggy. No, something spooky. I know, cried Froggy. Ghost Froggy. He poked two holes in his mother's best white sheet. Uh-oh. And draped it over his head. Ooh. Do you think he did a good job poking holes in his mother's sheet? I don't know. No, something scarier. I know, cried Froggy. Vampire Frog. He put on his black cape. Swoosh. Pulled on his mom's black tights. Zup. Put on his slick black wig. Zat. And said in his best Dracula voice, trick or treat, smell my feet. Give me something good to eat. If you don't, I don't care. I'll pull down your underwear. So silly, Froggy. Froggy! Called his mother. What? Halloween's not till next week. You're supposed to be doing your homework, dear.
I'm Count von Frogula, said Froggy.
Vampire frogs don't do homework. Froggy's mother laughed. Vampires have fangs, she said. You're a toothless wonder. Oops, cried Froggy, covering his mouth. So all week at school, Froggy wondered, what should I be for Halloween? A football player? A cowboy? A zombie? Froggy! Cried his teacher, Miss Witherspoon. What? Kindly keep your mind on your work, dear. So he was daydreaming, thinking about what he's going to be. He wasn't paying attention to school. But his mind was on Halloween. Every day after school, he got ready. He carved crazy pumpkins. He hung sticky spider webs all over the front of his house. He hung his mother's sheet like a ghost in the wind. And he practiced trick-or-treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat. If you don't, I don't care. I'll pull down your underwear. At last, it was the night before Halloween, and all through the house, there were creaking sound and scratching sounds. Froggy was scared. He shivered in bed and imagined ghosts and goblins and werewolves and witches. Witches! Zap! I know, cried Froggy. I'll be the Frog Prince for Halloween. Ooh, never heard of a Frog Prince. So sorry, guys. The book doesn't want to turn the page. And in the morning, he put on his black cape, swoosh, pulled on his mom's black tights, zup, and put on his slick black wig, zat, plunked on a gold crown, zunk, and flashed his mighty sword. Ta-da! So he's Frog Prince. At the Halloween parade at school, all the girls thought he looked cute, especially Frogalina. So Frog Frogolina thought he looked really cute. And that night, when the dark crept in and all the ghosts and goblins crept out to trick-or-treat, boo! Princess Frogolina leapt out and chased after the frog prince to give him a kiss. So look, there she went. Eek! Cried Froggy. He was never more scared in his life. He didn't look. Frogolina. It's crazy. He leapfrogged over his mother. He leapfrogged over his father. He leapfrogged over his friend Max and flopped up Max's steps. Flop, flop, splat! He tripped on the porch and Frogolina fell on top of him. The door flew open and uh-oh, there stood the wickedest witch in the world. Trick or treat, squeaked Froggy, looking more red in the face than green. Uh-oh. Luckily, Frogolina ran away and the witch turned out to be Max's granny. And that Halloween, Froggy got tons of candy, but his sword had torn a hole in his candy bag. Oh no. Do you see right here what's falling out of his bag? And by the time he got home, what do you think happened? His candy was all gone. Oh no, cried Froggy. What's the matter? Asked Mother. He showed her his empty bag. Well, you're in luck, said his mother, holding up a full bowl. I guess nobody liked my treats. And what do you think she gave him? Chocolate covered. What do you think frogs eat? Flies! Yum, cried Froggy, my favorite. Munch, crunch, munch. And that's the end of Froggy's Halloween. So what are you gonna be for Halloween? And maybe, what's your favorite candy? I don't know what I'm gonna be. And I love chocolate. All right, bye-bye.